ब्रेक के बाद आपका स्वागत है. हम हैं इन कॉन्वर्जेशन विद एस्मा वॉल्डर. सो एस्मा, वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट योर लाइफ, अबाउट हाउ यू वेंट इन विन योर टाइटल्स, योर स्टडीज. नाउ टेल मी वन थिंग, व्हाट आर योर फ्यूचर प्लान्स व्हेन इट कम्स टू फैमिली?
When it comes to family,
do you want to get married soon?
I would love to get married soon. Yes, I think having a family would be an absolutely beautiful experience. So I think when the right man comes along, I definitely will be willing to settle down and have a family of my own and pass on everything that I've learned to my children. I think being a mother is something that I've thought about recently as well. Looking at my mum and all the things she's done for me and how she helps with my brother. She cooks a lot for him because he has a condition back in Australia, which means he can only eat specific foods. And seeing her pour her heart out into the cooking, into looking after him, something that really inspires me and makes me want to be a good mother myself. And now when I see all the little children in India, I feel like my motherly nature is coming out as well. So yes, in the future, definitely have plans for a family.
Great. Tell me one thing, when for the first time you went out to work for the cause, for the underprivileged,
yes,
what was that feeling with when it was generally out of your heart, it was coming out, the work you were doing for them?
So emotional. It's something that keeps pulling me back. It's almost as if there are times when I feel like that's all I want to be doing. And even though that's slightly unrealistic, but once you've helped one child and you've seen them smile when you give them something and they look at you like their world has been changed for the better from one small gesture, it's something that being a part of just fills my heart with so much joy. So it's something that's very infectious for me and I want to continue doing, which is why I've started these projects myself. And that's why I'm back, because I want to see more of that happening in India and everywhere else that I go.
How many countries have you visited till now under this cause?
Under this cause, it's so far been India because the cause is in India, the one I've started. But when I was back in Bosnia, I did something very similar as well for the families that have been affected by the war. So I also started a GoFundMe account where a lot of people back at home donated funds, and we took a television show over to the families and we delivered the funds to those families that had sick children and that didn't have much food. So I've done these things whenever I can and wherever I've traveled. And like I said, I'm just hoping to do more and more of it.
Great. Esma, tell me something about yourself. You said you have you've gone for a lot of beauty pageants. Mm-hmm. For Miss Australia, you worked for four times you've applied for it.
Yes.
How difficult was it to accept being neglected?
Rejection is a very difficult feeling to go through in life with anything in general. It's disheartening when you keep getting a no, and when you sometimes go through those negative thoughts of, am I not good enough? Will this ever really happen? And all these thoughts get into your head. But for me, the dream was bigger than the fear. And I would always just sit back and take a rational look at things and go, well, it's not impossible. Technically, it is possible to win that crown. And studying psychology, I want to help motivate people to be better versions of themselves and to chase their dreams and to not let negativity stop them. So it was kind of like being my very own experiment. And I thought if I could push through that fear and push through those boundaries and push through those challenges and keep myself motivated and my self-esteem high enough, that example will speak for itself. Because it's one thing for me to go out there and say, believe in yourself, you can do it, dreams are possible, and then not do it.
Not
that would
do
be
it, right.
Such a shame, exactly. So I came second the year before I won, and there was a massive pressure that I put on myself to win after that result. Mm-hmm. Because I also knew that a lot of people were watching me and thought, well, is she going to win this year or not? And you think all these things
right.
in your head.
It all comes to your mind.
Exactly, and you think, what if I come top 10? It's the ego speaking right. in the end of the day. So for me, I thought that I have to be much bigger than my ego, and the fear is exactly why I did it. So I said, if I can beat this fear and that ego, then I've achieved something anyway. So I've won in so many ways. And when I won that crown, it was just like the cherry on top of the cake.
Oh, wow.
So it was a blessing, and I couldn't have been happier to achieve two things in one go.
Tell me one thing, when you were crowned, what was the first thought which came to your mind?
did they really say my name?
Oh, was that the thought which came to your
Yes,
mind?
it's one of those moments where they say your name and I almost didn't hear it because I don't know if that was my heart telling me that it wants to be me or was it actually, yeah, it was a bit of a surreal moment. It was a lot of a surreal moment, sorry. It was amazing. And then when the streamers come down, the crown gets put on your head and it becomes very real. Then I knew, yeah, it was
it
definitely,
was
yeah,
that
definitely,
was
definitely knew yeah. It was me when the crown was on my head. Then it all sank in, yes.
What was the reaction of your mother? Because you have spoken so highly about your mother.
Yes, she was crying.
Was she there in the audience?
Yes, she was. My father, my mother, and my brother were
all
there. All
three of them were there. Yeah,
yeah, she had tears in her eyes, and so did my dad, which was very sweet, and my brother as well. It was so good to have them there. Family support means everything to me.
Right. Esma, tell me one thing. Lot of women, lot of girls, young girls from India, they are also pursuing their career in modeling.
Mm-hmm.
What is that very important thing they should keep in mind? Because this will be a tip for them also.
I think the most important thing to keep in mind is your boundaries and your mental health when it comes to an industry that's quite focused on the way that you look. And I think all women are beautiful. So they just have to be mindful of where they want to draw the line with when things are getting too much for them, because there is a lot of pressure within the modeling industry. There is a lot of rejection, and sometimes there's not. Sometimes girls succeed very, very, very quickly, but that can also create high self expectations, and a whole range of issues come with that. So for me, I would just say, if you love it, do it, and do it in the way that you feel comfortable and the way that you love to do it, and don't listen and conform to the ways that you think things have to be done.
But do you think even if they want to get into a profession which is modeling,
yes,
education is very important. They should complete their education before getting into this profession?
Before, during, it doesn't matter when, but I do think having an education is one of the greatest tools you can
and
ever
especially
have
for
in
girl
life.
Child.
Yes, of course, especially. Well, education has helped me be a better model because it helps you notice what's a good opportunity, and you can do something and develop your own profile so you can be more than a model. And it's okay if you choose not to study, that's a personal choice, but in the end of the day knowledge is power, and learning is so exciting. So whatever your passion is, it doesn't necessarily have to be a science or a maths. It could be something creative, it could be learning design or learning about the economy. So it doesn't have to be that one way.
Great. Asma, if you want to be choose another profession apart from modeling,
yes,
apart from a beauty queen, what would it be and why?
I'd say working in trauma therapy would be really, really great. So in Australia, I did a little bit of criminal profiling, assisting in criminal profiling in psychology. And I've seen that trauma and fears and past experiences can really prevent someone from functioning properly and doing their absolute best. And it can just create a lot of barriers between them getting what they want and living a better quality of life. So things like anxieties and depressions that are linked to past experiences, that's something I would really love to help coach people through and nurture their emotions through that, because we are emotional creatures and sometimes it's very easy to lose sight of what's rational and what's logical because we get overly emotional. And if we can help to regulate that in people and learn how to control that, I think people can become a lot more empowered. So it's something I still think I want to do. Yeah, I mean, hopefully there's 24 hours in a day.
If there's more, I'm sure you'll do a lot more.
If there was more, exactly. Yeah. So hopefully something in the future within that field would be amazing.
Wow. It's great to hear what all you've spoken to us about. Okay, if you want to get into films, are you good with singing? Do you sing?
Lip sing?
Just lip sing? You don't sing?
Look, I can sing, but whether I'm good or not,
so it's all right.
That's a different story.
Just sing two lines for our audiences.
Two lines?
Yeah, anything, any song which you
really?
Like. Yeah, yeah.
I've barely sung it. Okay.
This will be a plus point for you to get into a film with Shah Rukh Khan.
I'm just trying to think of what song to sing. Put me on the spot. If I can think of a song, I will sing it. She's so lucky. She's a star, but she cries with her lonely heart, thinking, if there's nothing missing in my life, then why do these tears come at night?
Great, beautiful. I think it was beautiful.
That
I'm
was
sure
beautiful.
If no, it was. It was amazing. I'm sure if anybody has to listen to you from Bollywood, they'll take in the picture.
Okay. That's the first time I've sung in public.
That's nice. Mm-hmm. Okay, one last question I would like to ask you. From Jaipur, once you go back, what all memories are you going to take back to Australia?
To Australia, I'll take back meeting you, of course, and having this amazing conversation.
Oh, great. Thank you so much.
It's been lovely. And the smiles on the faces of the students that I visited today after Dr. Satish Sikka and I spoke to them, seeing them feel inspired and encouraged to do more and create more within their design, whatever else that they're studying, that is a memory that will stick with me. And hopefully there's going to be more in the next 2 days that I can take back.
So we wish you loads and loads of luck for whatever you're doing in life, and we hope you achieve what you want to achieve.
Thank you so much.
तो जैसे कि आपने देखा, ये थी एस्मा वॉलडर, जिन्होंने की खूब सारी बातें हमारे साथ. जल्द हाजिर होंगे एक नए मेहमान के साथ. तब तक के लिए थैंक यू एंड गुड बाय.